Hello, artists. It's getting so cold out. I thought it would be fun to create hot cocoa artwork. Hot cocoa is one of my favorite drinks when it gets cold out. Today, we will be working in the style of contemporary artist Heather Gawler. We will create hot cocoa art. We will be using lines and patterns and lots of colors to create exciting hot cocoa artwork. Let's take a look at some of Heather Gawler's artwork.
I want to introduce to you an amazing artist. She's a contemporary artist. This means that she is still working and painting today. She's probably in her studio right now painting. Her name is Heather Gawler. She is considered a folk artist because she's self-taught. She did not go to art school. Heather Gawler paints pets, flowers, angels, landscapes, and hot chocolate. Heather Gawler also paints pet portraits. For $250, you can commission her to paint your pet in her unique style. Heather Gawler has received many awards for her artwork, and she sold over 750 paintings in just 5 years. Inspired by her today, we are going to paint our own exciting cup of hot chocolate. Let's get started. You will need a sheet of mixed media paper and a pencil. Before we begin, I want you to think about different shapes of cups. How do you want your hot cocoa cup to look? We're going to be drawing a basic cup together, but you can change it and make it more exciting. Start by drawing a flat oval. This is the top of the cup. Draw the sides of the cup. Look how my lines curve towards the bottom. Draw the bottom of the cup. This line should be curved to make your cup look 3D. Now, draw the line that represents your hot chocolate. You can see inside of your cup. All hot cups need a handle. Draw a curved line and the inner line of the cup handle. Now, let's draw a saucer for the cup, a large oval or ellipse. Now, draw the bottom edge of the saucer to give your saucer a 3D look. Using a Sharpie, outline your pencil lines. Now you can really see the shape of your cup and saucer. Erase any extra pencil lines. Now, I want you to think about different types of lines. Get your oil pastels. How do you want to decorate your hot cocoa cup? Here I'm using dots and lines. Notice my lines are a little curved to help give my cup a 3D look. Now I'm drawing zigzag lines, shading in the bottom of the saucer, and a few more dots. Get your watercolor paints. I'm painting the hot chocolate a brown. Now I've decided I want my cup to be yellow, and the handle too. And my saucer is going to be a different color. There's red in my cup, so I thought red on the saucer would look good. How are you painting your cup of hot chocolate? What colors are you using? I'm going to use a little bit of purple to add a little bit of a shadow under the cup. A little bit more. Put your painting somewhere safe to dry and get your construction paper. You'll need your oil pastels, scissors, and a glue stick. Select two colors of your choice. I picked purple and blue. Blue will be the table and purple will be the background. Notice how I'm folding the blue in half and cutting the blue in half. Now I'm thinking about different types of lines. I'm drawing vertical lines with my blue, and I'm coming back and drawing some dotted lines between the blue lines. This could be the tablecloth. I want this to look fancy. Okay, now I'm going to design the wall behind the cup. I'm drawing diagonal lines in yellow, and then I'm going to come back the other way and draw a diagonal line so that the lines intersect. Now with a light green oil pastel, I'm drawing diamonds inside of the diamond shape. I want the wallpaper behind the hot cocoa to look fancy. This isn't just any cup of hot cocoa. This is my dream cup of hot cocoa. I'm going to be adding all of my favorite toppings. Okay, there's a lot of patterns here and designs. This will be a great background for my cup of hot chocolate. Now that the hot chocolate picture is dry, get your scissors and cut it out. Carefully, as close to the black line as you can get. Make sure you save the pieces of white paper around the hot chocolate. We're going to use them. It can be tricky to cut out the white space in the middle of the handle. So what I'm doing is I'm cutting the handle so that I can get inside of the white area, and then I'm removing the space inside of the handle. Now, I want you to think about all of the exciting things you can add to hot cocoa. Marshmallows, whipped cream, cookie sticks, peppermint sticks, chocolate sprinkles. What do you want to add to your hot cocoa? What would make it a really special drink? I've decided I'm going to add marshmallows. And notice I'm drawing a little bit of the top of the marshmallow to give it a 3D look. I'm cutting out my marshmallows and a lot of whipped cream. I also decided to have a straw too so that I could sip my cocoa. How do you like to drink your cocoa? What toppings do you want to add to your hot cocoa? This is the deluxe cocoa. If you could put anything in it, what would you put in yours? I'm using a little bit of red to decorate my straw with. Also, I'd like you to add some steam to show that your hot cocoa is warm. I'm using a piece of scrap paper to draw some steam to show that my hot chocolate is hot. Now I'm outlining the steam with a Sharpie and I'm going to cut out the pieces. I have a lot of exciting toppings for my hot chocolate. I can't wait to see the toppings in your hot cocoa. Okay, everything is cut out. And I'm ready to put it all together. This is my dream cup of hot chocolate, the perfect cup for a cold day. Now you need glue and your background. Before we glue anything together, let's see how all of the pieces fit together. Okay, I've got marshmallows, I've got whipped cream, I've got the steam, and my straw. I've decided to add a little bit of shading to the steam and a little bit of shading to the whipped cream. I'm going to glue the cup onto the paper first, and I'm putting it down closer to the bottom of the paper because I need to leave room for steam. If you turn your paper over and rub the back of the paper, count to five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this will help everything stick better. There's my whipped cream in the center and my straw, and I have four marshmallows, so in order to make them fit, I'm gonna have to overlap them, but that's okay. I mean, if you put a lot of marshmallows in your hot chocolate, they're gonna be overlapped because they float right on the top. And here's the steam to show that my hot chocolate is hot, because on a cold day, that's the best way to drink hot chocolate. Pieces are glued. To help everything stick, I'm going to turn my paper over and rub the back of the paper and count to five. It's finished. Heather Gawler inspired hot chocolate.
I had so much fun drawing hot cocoa with you today. Please upload your finished pictures into our new Artsonia hot cocoa gallery. Thank you.